But also, Ashesha, that was important stocks, but Radico Khaitan, that's something that reported its numbers as well. Seems like a good set of numbers came in from the company. Could you give us a breakdown on how it's looking like? What are you doing in terms of the number crunching? Anything interesting there?
Well, yes, very strong set of numbers that have come in from Radico Khaitan this time around. Revenues have seen an uptick of a solid 47% on a year-on-year basis. And a good set of numbers this time around was aided by volume growth, especially from the prestige and above segment. Margins have also expanded by as much as 50 basis points on a year-on-year basis. Let's talk about the volumes in particular. As I mentioned, prestige and above segment was what aided growth. P&A segment has seen a solid volume uptick of 20% on a year-on-year basis, and IMFL segment on a whole has reported growth of about 4%, and that is because the popular segment declined by as much as 11 to 13%, but P&A segment is what aided growth this time around. As far as the net debt figure is concerned, that too has declined by nearly 15% on a sequential basis, and analysts believe that declining debt trend indicates that perhaps debt cycle has probably peaked out in the previous quarter. Meanwhile, we also have a note that has come in from Investec, where they say that the results were very good in the quarter gone by. They continue to deliver strong earnings growth despite ENA-led headwinds in the last couple of quarters. Innovation also continues, especially with the new launch, a new product launch that they have done. So all in all, a strong set of numbers, P&A segment-led growth, and net debt has also declined, and brokerages have also given a thumbs up.
Okay, Ashesha, thank you so much for that. But